Hey guys, the question is, the following information concern production in the baking department for August. All direct materials are placed in process at the beginning of production. Here is our data. Based on the above data, determine each cost below, listed below. Direct material cost per equivalent unit, conversion cost per equivalent unit, cost of the beginning work in process completed during August, and here is our other information. So first of all, we will calculate equivalent units. So whole units, inventory in August, inventory in process on March 1st, 8,100 units. And here, equivalent units for direct material, it will be 0. And for conversion, it will be 8,100 multiplied by 1 minus 2 by 5 completed. So 1 minus 2 by 5 is equal to 3 by 5. 4,860 started and completed in March. So here, first of all, started and completed in March. First of all, we will take started and completed in March is equal to our goods finished 147,600 minus beginning 8,100. So 139,500, and here transfer to finished goods 147,600. Here 139,500 will be for direct material, and for conversion it is 139,500 multiplied, sorry, again here also 139,500. Now transfer to finished goods 147,600 whole units, and for direct material 147,600, and for conversion 144,360. Sorry, here it is 0. Now on inventory in process on March 31st. Inventory in process on March 31st. Here it is equal to our, one second, plus our production is of 145,800 minus finished 147,600. So our total will be 153,900. Now 6,300 will be for direct material, and for conversion 6,300 multiplied by 3 by 5, 3,780. Now we had to calculate direct material cost per equivalent unit. So here direct material cost per equivalent unit is equal to total cost divided by total equivalent unit. Here total cost for direct material is total cost is $291,600 divided by our equivalent units for direct material, sorry, 145,800. So here it is equal to $2. Now our conversion cost per equivalent unit here, conversion cost is total direct labor and factory overheads 85,330 plus 47,996, then divide by total equivalent units for conversion, 148,140. So here it is equal to 0.9 dollar per unit. Now we will calculate cost of the beginning work in process completed during August. Cost of beginning work in process completed during August here it is equal to 18,954 plus our equivalent units for conversion 4,860 multiplied by our cost conversion cost per equivalent unit 0.9 dollar. Now we will calculate cost of units started and completed. Cost of units started and completed during August. Here it is equal to 139,500 multiplied by $2 plus 139,500 multiplied by 0.9 dollar. So here it is equal to 404,550 dollar. Now we will calculate cost of units started and completed during August year, cost of ending work in process. Cost of ending work in process is equal to 6,300 multiplied by $2 plus 3,780 units multiplied by 0.9 dollar. Six thousand 300 multiplied by $2 and 3,700. $16,002. Now cost of ending, assuming that the direct material cost is the same for July and August, did the conversion cost per equivalent unit decrease, increase, or if it remains same? So here our conversion cost incurred beginning work in process minus direct material cost, here So here are our solutions. In case any doubt, you can ask me through comment box, and don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and hit the bell icon. Thank you for watching my solution.